allyl iodide. Glycerol reacts with phosphorus triiodide or iodine. Glycerol to allyl iodide. Okay, glycerol CH2OH, CH2OH, CH2OH reacts with HI or Pi3 or iodine. CH2OH, CH2OH, CH2OH glycerol reacts with hydrochloric acid or HI or Pi3, otherwise iodine, anyone ionizing agent. Now all what you convert into iodine, so CH2I, CHI, CH2I, stable or unstable? Highly unstable, so ready to decompose it. Okay, so what will happen? Removal of iodine, single bond become gear to make a double bond. So product is CH2 double bond CH bond single bond CH2I, namely allyl iodide. Allyl iodide. So you know how to prepare glycerol to allyl iodide. Then glycerol to acrolein. Glycerol to acrolein. Glycerol to acrolein. Okay. Glycerol CH2OH. CH2. For replacing purpose, I'm going to write like this. Okay. CH2OH. CHOH. CH2OH. Nothing but what? Glycerol. Okay. Glycerol reacts with potassium bisulfate, KHSO4. Potassium bisulfate. Glycerol reacts with potassium bisulfate. It gives one unstable compound. One unstable compound. That means removal of water. Removal of two water molecules. Removal of two water molecules. So, CH2 double bond C double bond CHOH, that is one unstable compound. Finally, internal rearrangement reaction takes place. This H will remove from this place to here. This double bond become here to make a bond with C and H to form a CH. Look at my CHO. So CH2 double bond CH single bond CHO is named as what? Acrolein. Okay, CH2 double bond CH, single bond CH, namely acrolein. Then glycerol reacts with oxalic acid at 383 Kelvin. 383 Kelvin. Glycerol with oxalic acid. Glycerol with oxalic acid. Glycerol CH2OH bond CHOH bond CH2OH. Oxalic acid formula COOH 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 twice. So that is nothing but oxalic acid. Now here removal of water. Removal of water. So what is the remaining part? CH2 single bond O, C double bond O, then COOH. Remaining acid is CHOH, here CH2OH. Okay. Then followed by decarboxylation reaction takes place. How much here? 383 Kelvin. 383 Kelvin. Then only you can remove water molecule. Okay. Then what do you mean decarboxylation reaction? Decarboxylation reaction mean removal of carbon dioxide. Removal of carbon dioxide. So removal of carbon dioxide. Removal of CO2. So what's the product now? CH2 bond OCOH. OCOH. Remaining CHOH bond CH2OH. Okay. Namely glycerol monoformate. Glycerol monoformate. Because HCOOH is formic acid. Okay. Named as glycerol monoformate. The next one. Glycerol reacts with oxalic acid at 533 Kelvin. 533 Kelvin. Very same glycerol with oxalic acid. Glycerol with oxalic acid means COOH, COOH. Okay. At 533 Kelvin. Now removal of two water molecules. Removal of two water molecules. So product is CH2 bond OOC, CH bond OOC, remaining CH2OH, followed by decarboxylation reaction. Decarboxylation reaction means what? Removal of carbon dioxide. Removal of carbon dioxide. So product is CH2 double bond CH bond CH2OH. This group alone name is allyl. Allyl have one OH mean, namely allyl alcohol. They can ask question like this. How to prepare allyl alcohol from glycerol? Glycerol to allyl alcohol. Or how to prepare allyl alcohol from glycerol. So using oxalic acid, you are going to heat at 533 Kelvin. You can prepare easily allyl alcohol. Then aromatic alcohols. You know what is aromatic alcohol? Aromatic. What do you mean? What is the meaning of aromatic? Amma? What mean aroma mean very pleasant smell, isn't it? Aroma mean very pleasant smell. Here we are going to discuss about aromatic alcohols. Aromatic alcohol. That means aroma mean aromatic compounds contain one benzene ring. Alcohol mean OH. Then in benzene ring you cannot directly OH group, or that OH group present in side chain also. OH group is bonded with directly benzene ring mean that named as phenol. That named as phenol. That OH group present in side chain mean that named as benzyl alcohol. Benzyl alcohol. Clear? If hydroxyl group present in the directly bonded with benzene ring mean that named as phenol. The hydroxyl group present in side chain mean named as benzyl alcohol. This is the example of R-alkyl alcohol. R-alkyl. This R aromatic group. This alkyl group. That is alcohol. Namely R-alkyl alcohol. R-alkyl. Alcohol. Okay, here the very important reaction. First one is Cannizzaro reaction. In next lesson, in carbonyl compounds, we are going to study full and full detail about mechanism also in Cannizzaro reaction. Here only 3 mark question. What is Cannizzaro reaction? Clear? Cannizzaro reaction. Cannizzaro nothing but who discovered this reaction, scientist name. Listen, in Cannizzaro reaction, aldehyde is going to involve. Which molecule? Not alcohol ethers, only aldehyde. But aldehyde means so many aldehyde is present, isn't it? formaldehyde, acetaldehyde, benzaldehyde, cinnamaldehyde, salicylaldehyde, so many aldehydes available. Okay. So which type of aldehyde only involving in the kinase of the reaction mean? Which aldehyde does not containing alpha hydrogen atom? That type of aldehyde only involving in the kinase of reaction. Clear? So aldehyde mean listen. For example, formaldehyde, acetaldehyde, then benzaldehyde, trimethyl acetaldehyde, cinnamaldehyde, salicylaldehyde, so many aldehydes possible. Clear? So which type of aldehyde involving alpha hydrogen atom mean the aldehyde does not containing alpha hydrogen atom, that type of aldehyde only involving the kinase of reaction. Okay, that mean formaldehyde whether having alpha hydrogen or not. Formaldehyde have alpha hydrogen or not? Having alpha hydrogen? Yes or no? No, because there is no alpha hydrogen, alpha carbon. Sorry, there is no alpha hydrogen. So formaldehyde undergoes kinase of reaction. What about acetaldehyde? You know what is alpha carbon? Adjacent to the functional group. This functional group means nothing but alpha carbon. That carbon have any hydrogen mean that named as alpha hydrogen atom. Clear? Okay, now acetaldehyde contains 3 alpha hydrogen atom. So this is not involved in the kinase of the reaction. This type of aldehyde undergoes another reaction, namely aldol condensation reaction, not kinase of the reaction. Clear? Okay. Now here benzaldehyde contains alpha hydrogen atom or not? Benzaldehyde contains alpha hydrogen or not? Yes or no? Yes or no? Benzaldehyde contains alpha hydrogen or not? No. Yes or no? Why it contains 5 alpha hydrogen? No. Very good. Because see the benzaldehyde structure. This is the benzaldehyde. Clear? This is alpha carbon. Okay, the first carbon. This carbon any hydrogen atom? No, because all 4 bond only present. 1, 2, 3, 4. There is no alpha hydrogen. So that benzaldehyde involved in the kinase of reaction. What about trimethyl acetaldehyde? Here also there is no alpha hydrogen atom. There is alpha hydrogen. So this also involved in the kinase of reaction. So this type of aldehyde is involved in the kinase of reaction. What is the condition? The aldehyde does not contain alpha hydrogen atom. So formaldehyde, benzaldehyde, trimethyl acetaldehyde, these type of aldehydes are involved in the kinase of reaction. They will ask one more question. Which aldehyde does not undergo kinase of reaction? Your options are formaldehyde, acetaldehyde, benzaldehyde, trimethyl acetaldehyde. Does not undergo kinase of reaction. Because acetaldehyde contains 3 alpha hydrogen atom. That's why that type of aldehyde involved in the aldol condensation reaction, not a kinase of reaction. Clear? Okay. You will see now, kinase of reaction means benzaldehyde undergoes kinase of reaction. So, C6H5 bond CHO. Okay. C6H5 bond CH. I am going to take 2 molecules of benzaldehyde. Okay. This is a redox reaction. You know what is redox reaction? What's the meaning of redox reaction? Both reduction as well as oxidation takes place simultaneously. Reduction as well as oxidation takes place simultaneously. Here, both are aldehyde. Clear? So, out of these 2 aldehyde, one aldehyde undergoes oxidation reaction, another aldehyde undergoes reduction reaction. So, one aldehyde undergoes oxidation reaction to form a aldehyde undergoes oxidation reaction. What is the product? Benzoic acid. So, benzaldehyde means benzoic acid is the product. Now another aldehyde undergoes reduction reaction means aldehyde undergoes reduction reaction, what is the product? Primary alcohol then? So benzyl alcohol. Benzyl alcohol. So here I am going to add water. Reaction takes place in the presence of base. Sodium hydroxide is the best example. Okay, sodium hydroxide NaOH. Now listen. Otherwise if you get H2O, water molecule means H2OH. Here O, here OH. That means COOH, CH2OH. Clear? So, one of the aldehyde undergoes oxidation reaction, C6H5 bond COOH, benzoic acid, another aldehyde whose reduction reactant, namely benzyl alcohol, CH2OH, named as benzoic acid, named as benzyl alcohol. Both are same type of aldehyde, means there is nothing but simple kinesoro reaction. Cross kinesoro reaction means some different aldehyde. Okay, different aldehyde mean what? One is a formaldehyde, another one is benzaldehyde. One is formaldehyde, another one is benzaldehyde. Very same water, the presence of NaOH, the presence of NaOH. Here, formaldehyde undergoes oxidation reaction to become a formic acid product. This benzaldehyde undergoes reduction reaction to form a benzyl alcohol is the product. Because comparing benzyl alcohol, benzaldehyde, formaldehyde undergoes easily oxidation takes place, so that formaldehyde gives formic acid, benzaldehyde gives benzyl alcohol. So products are HCOOH, formic acid, here benzyl alcohol, C6H5CH2OH. This is nothing but what? Kinesoro reaction. First one is simple kinesoro reaction. This is nothing but simple kinesoro reaction. This is nothing but crossed kinesoro reaction. Any doubt? H2O, sorry. Yeah, HH, because CH2OH, H2O. H2O, very good, H2O. Clear, CH2OH. Okay, the next one is, first process from chlorobenzene. This is what? Chlorobenzene reacts with sodium hydroxide at 623 Kelvin and 300 atmospheric pressure, it gives phenol. Then one more method also is there. Chlorobenzene reacts with water in the presence of silica, it gives phenol. Okay, with the same chlorobenzene, C6H5Cl reacts with water, the presence of silica, SiO2. Now H and Cl, removal of HCl. What's the remaining? C6H5OH plus HCl, named as what? Phenol. Named as phenol. Third one from sulfonic acid. Aromatic sulfonic acids are reacts with sodium hydroxide to form respective sodium salt of sulfonic acids. Then the sodium salt of sulfonic acid reacts with 2 molecules of sodium hydroxide at 573 Kelvin, it gives sodium phenoxide. Now we will see first equation. Aromatic sulfonic acid means ArSO3H. Ar means aromatic group. Aryl group. Nothing but CH5. Phenyl group. That's aryl group. Aromatic sulfonic acid reacts with what? Sodium hydroxide. Now, removal of water. Removal of water. So, what's the product now? ArSO3Na plus water. Sodium salt of aromatic sulfonic acid. Sodium salt of aromatic sulfonic acid is the product. Okay. Now, this sodium salt of aromatic sulfonic acid reacts with how many NaOH? Two molecules of NaOH. Two molecules of NaOH. Now, at how much Kelvin? 573 Kelvin. 573 Kelvin. Okay. 573 Kelvin. Listen ma, now removal of sodium phenoxide is the product. Sodium phenoxide. So, first removal of one water molecule. Okay. Then Na2SO3. Na2SO3. Sodium sulfide. What is the remaining? ArONa. ArONa. So, ArONa, sodium phenoxide plus sodium sulfide plus water. Okay. Then, in sodium phenoxide, ArONa mean sodium phenoxide reacts with HCl. That sodium ArONa reacts with what? HCl. Now, removal of NaCl. removal of NaCl. What's the remaining? Ar OH. Ar. What do you mean Ar? Aryl group. Aryl mean C6H5. OH mean nothing but phenol. So first method, namely Dow's process. Chlorobenzene reacts with sodium hydroxide at 623 Kelvin in the presence of 300 atmospheric pressure, it uses phenol. Second method, chlorobenzene reacts with water molecule in the presence of silica, it gives phenol. Third method, from aromatic sulfonic acid. Aromatic sulfonic acid reacts with sodium hydroxide. Sodium salt of aromatic sulfonic acid is the product. Then the sodium salt of aromatic sulfonic acid reacts with two molecules of sodium hydroxide at 573 Kelvin, it gives sodium phenoxide. Sodium phenoxide. Now sodium phenoxide decomposes with HCl to form a phenol. Then fourth one is from benzene disodium chloride. Benzene disodium chloride reacts with water molecule in the presence of acid. Benzene disodium chloride reacts with water in the presence of acid medium, it gives phenol. Benzene C6H5 diazonium azomine nitrogen, diazomine N2. So benzene disodium chloride reacts with water in the presence of acid medium. Now 1H and 1Cl, removal of HCl, then removal of nitrogen. What's the product? C6H5OH. C6H5OH phenol plus HCl plus nitrogen. It's named as what? That's the fourth. It's named as benzene disodium chloride. Okay. Then the fifth method is a decarboxylation of phenolic acids. Sodium salicylate reacts with soda lime. When you are heating, it gives phenol. Sodium salicylate means OH COONA. Sodium salicylate. When you add soda lime means mixture of sodium hydroxide and CaO, that is soda lime. When you are heating this mixture, you will get, listen mom, Na and Na, Na2, CO2, one more O is present, so Na2CO3, removal of Na2CO3, this H will come here, isn't it? All the corner carbon have hydrogen atom, okay? So product is one benzene ring. Have one OH plus Na2CO3. It's named as what? Phenol. Then that is sixth method. That is a very important method. Preparation of phenol. Benzene to phenol. So this is benzene disodium chloride reacts with water molecule in the presence of acid medium, it gives phenol. Here sodium salicylate reacts with soda lime. When heating the mixture, you will get phenol. The sixth method, very important method. Sometimes separately they are asking problem part. How to prepare phenol from benzene. Not only theory part, that is very important for problem part. So first, benzene reacts with propylene. In the presence of aluminium chloride, you will get cumene. Then cumene reacts with oxygen to form cumene hydroperoxide. Cumene hydroperoxide undergoes acid hydrolysis reaction. You will get phenol and acetone. Okay. Initially, we are going to take benzene. What is this? Benzene. Reacts with propylene. Propylene means CH2 double bond CH bond CH3. This reaction takes place in the presence of aluminium chloride. See the product, very same benzene ring. Okay, listen ma. Now all the carbon have one hydrogen, no? All the carbon containing one hydrogen atom, isn't it? So, listen, I am going to take this CH in the middle. Okay. Then this methyl group. Here the CH2 combine with that hydrogen to form a CH3. Clear? So one more methyl. Can you able to understand? This named as cumene. C-U-M-E-N-E. This named as what? Benzene. Positive over. Benzene to cumene. Benzene to cumene. In second step, cumene reacts with oxygen to form cumene hydroperoxide. Cumene hydroperoxide. So that cumene, there will be one CH contained, two methyl group. Clear? One CH contained two methyl group. Otherwise, easy to understand. I am writing like this itself. CH3 bond CH3. What's the name? Cumene. Reacts with air. Reacts with air. Cumene hydroperoxide. Listen, ma. I am going to add two oxygen atom in between. Already CH is there now. In between C and H, two oxygen. Already CH is present in cumene. I am going to add two oxygen where? In between the C and H. Okay. So, the product will come like this. One C. Okay. Already two methyl group is present. CH3, CH3, two methyl group. Okay. Already one H is there. In between what? OO. So, nothing but what? Cumene hydroperoxide. Hydroperoxide. Third step, this cumene hydroperoxide. Cumene hydroperoxide undergoes acid hydrolysis, isn't it? The process of acid hydrolysis takes place. Now listen very carefully. Removal of ketone, acetone. CH3CO acetone. What is remaining? Phenol. So, phenol plus acetone. CH3CO bond CH3Acetone. This is only our own product, namely phenol. So, in the sixth method is there. Okay. You can prepare phenol in this sixth method. Clear? The preparation of phenol. Then, using phenol, phenol to benzene. How to prepare benzene from phenol? Or how to convert phenol to benzene? How to convert phenol to benzene? Or how to prepare benzene to benzene from phenol? Phenol to benzene. In phenol, you are going to add zinc dust. You will get benzene. So, phenol means C6H5OH. You are going to add zinc dust. Then, you will get zinc oxide and benzene. Benzene C6H6 plus Z10O. That's the phenol converted to benzene. Clear? In phenol, you are going to add zinc dust. You will get benzene. You will get benzene. The next reaction is Cotton-Bowman reaction. Phenol reacts with benzyl chloride in the presence of NaOH to form Cotton-Bowman reaction. Cotton-Bowman reaction. Cotton-Bowman reaction. Phenol reacts with benzyl chloride. Phenol means C6H5OH. Benzyl chloride C6H5COCl. Reaction takes place in the presence of base like NaOH. What's the product reactant name? Phenol benzyl chloride. Benzyl chloride. Now, removal of HCl. Removal of HCl. Remaining acetate is namely phenylbenzoate. C6H5OCO, C6H5, namely phenylbenzoate is the product plus HCl. This is one of the name reaction, namely Stoughton-Bowman reaction. Stoughton-Bowman reaction. So, Stoughton-Bowman reaction means phenol reacts with benzyl chloride in the presence of strong alkali like NaOH to form phenylbenzoate. It's a very important reaction. The next one is reacts with ammonia. Phenol reacts with ammonia in the presence of zinc chloride. You will get aniline. This equation is very important for problem. Phenol reacts with ammonia in the presence of zinc chloride at 473 Kelvin. Phenol formula H5OH reacts with ammonia mean NH3. Reaction takes place in the presence of zinc chloride and 473 Kelvin. Clear? Now, 1H from ammonia. 1H from ammonia. So, remaining only 2 hydrogen. H and OH remove of water molecule. So, you will get C6H5 bond NH2. This named as what? Aniline. Aminobenzene nothing but what? Aniline. What is the product name? Aniline. Then, halogenation reaction. Halogenation reaction. Halogenation reaction mean addition of halogen. Addition of halogen. Okay. Now, in phenol, you are going to add bromine. This bromine water. Bromine water in bromine and water. Here, excess of bromine you are going to add. Excess of bromine mean the product is already phenol is present. Here 2, 4, 6, all the positions you can attach substitute bromine. Named as what? This 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Where and all the bromine is present? 2, 2nd carbon, 4th carbon, 6th carbon. So namely 2, 4, 6 tribromophenol. 2, 4, 6 tribromophenol. 2, 4, 6 tribromophenol. Very same thing, you are going to have very less amount. Very less amount, instead of 3 molecules, only 2 molecules of bromine. The presence of carbon tetrachloridamine. Carbon tetrachloridamine, you will get orthobromophenol and parabromophenol. This is phenol. Very same thing. Whenever you will get ortho product, very same. Simultaneously, you will get para also. You know what is ortho meta para? This main group present here means the adjacent carbon is ortho. Alternatives are meta. Opposites are para. So here you will get one ortho, one Br means para also, one Br. Namely ortho bromo phenol, here para bromo phenol. So you, if you add excess bromine mean you will get 2,4,6 tribromo phenol. Clear? If you add excess bromine, you will get 2,4,6 tribromo phenol. If you add only 2 molecules of bromine mean you will get ortho bromo phenol and para bromo phenol. Okay. Then very same like halogenation, nitration reaction. What's the reaction? Nitration reaction. Nitration reaction takes place in the presence of nitration mixer. You know what is nitration mixer? What is nitration mixer? Not that mixer. Mixer of concentrated nitric acid and concentrated sulfuric acid. That named as nitration, nitrate mixer. So what is the what is electrophile? These are the electrophilic substitution reaction. Okay. So we are going to add in phenol now. So phenol undergoes what is the reaction name is nitration reaction. Nitration reaction. In phenol, that is a phenol undergoes phenol nitration reaction mean nitration reaction takes place in the presence of nitration mixture. Nitration mixture mean mixture of concentrated nitric acid and concentrated sulfuric acid. Your electrophile is what? NO2 plus, nitronium group. NO2 plus only electrophile. Very concentrated acid. Okay. So reaction takes place vigorously. You will get all the positions. Here is the phenol mean. Second position, fourth position, sixth position, all position you will add sucrose. Nitro. So named as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Where are the nitrous present? So the product name is 2,4,6-trinitrophenol. 2,4,6-trinitro. Very same nitration reaction takes place in dilute nitric acid mean. Instead of concentrated acid, dilute mean, you will get only ortho and para products. Ortho nitrophenol and para nitrophenol. Very same phenol, but instead of concentrated nitric acid and sulfuric acid, dilute nitric acid mean, you will get the product, but you will get only ortho and para product. So, this is a phenol, this is also what? Phenol. Ortho nitrophenol and para nitrophenol. This is nothing but which reaction? Nitration reaction. Then, nitrosation reaction. Nitrosation reaction mean you have to add nitrous acid. Nitrous acid mean HNO2. HNO2. Here you have to add which group? NO. So you will get para nitrosophenol. Para nitrosophenol. Listen ma. Phenol is nothing but what? Nitrosation reaction. Nitrosation reaction. Phenol reacts with HNO2 nitrous acid at 200 Kelvin. You will get para nitrosophenol. Already phenol is present. Here already what is the already H is there now? Already H is present all the carbon atom. That H NO2 only now. Okay, HNO2. Now NO I want to add here. HHO removal of water molecule. Clear? Removal of water. So I am going to add here NO. Namely para nitrosophenol. Para nitrosophenol. The next one is very important paper, that is last one. Coupling reaction. Nothing but diformation reaction. Coupling reaction nothing but diformation reaction. Coupling reaction means benzene disodium chloride couples with phenol in the presence of 273 Kelvin. The base, it gives para hydroxyazobenzene. It's nothing but orange color dye. Clear? So what is coupling reaction? Very important reaction. Nothing but diformation reaction. Diformation reaction. See what is coupling reaction. Coupling is nothing but diformation reaction. Benzene disodium chloride. C6H5 N double bond NCl. Benzene disodium chloride. You want structure mean instead of phenyl group? Nothing but what? Benzene disodium chloride. Couples with phenol. Phenol mean one benzene ring contains OH group. This carbon contains what? Hydrogen. Reaction takes place in the presence of base at 273 Kelvin. 273 Kelvin. Now removal of HCl. Remaining acids you are going to write. What does acids mean? One benzene ring, N double bond N, another benzene ring and OH. In para position hydroxy is there. So namely para hydroxy azo benzene. That is nothing but red orange dye. Red orange dye. Dye formation reaction. So coupling reaction means benzene disodium chloride couples with phenol in the presence of base at 273 Kelvin to form a para hydroxy azo benzene. Para hydroxy azobenzene. The next reaction is coal preaction. The reaction coal preaction. Sodium phenoxide reacts with carbon dioxide 400 Kelvin, 4 to 7 atmospheric pressure. It gives sodium salicylate. Then the sodium salicylate will decompose with HCl to form a salicylic acid. Okay. Now to keep on remind that one. Coupling reaction mean OH minus 273 Kelvin. Coal preaction mean CO2 400 Kelvin 4 to 7 atmospheric pressure. Very 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 important reaction. Coal preaction. Okay. Coal reaction. It's an initial reaction. Initial reactant sodium phenoxide. Sodium phenoxide mean benzene ring ONA. Sodium phenoxide. Sodium phenoxide. What are the conditions? CO2 400 Kelvin 4 to 7 atmospheric pressure. 4 to 7 atmospheric pressure. You know all the carbons of hydrogen, I am going to indicate only this poison alone. Okay. Listen now. Our product is, listen ma, this O and H from OH over here. O and H form a OH. We are going to introduce CO2. So you can write here COO. Already Na is present. So COO Na. You able to understand? This name the sodium salicylate. Sodium salicylate. This sodium salicylate will decompose with HCl. Now removal of NaCl. Removal of NaCl. So COO H will come here to form a salicylic acid. Benzene ring OH here COOH, namely not cyclic, salicylic acid or ortho-hydroxybenzoic acid. Ortho-hydroxybenzoic acid nothing but salicylic acid. Clear? So coal preaction means sodium phenoxide reacts with carbon dioxide at 400 Kelvin and 4 to 7 atmospheric pressure. It gives sodium salicylate. The sodium salicylate will decompose with HCl to form salicylic acid. Clear? The next very important reaction, Reimer-Thiemann reaction. That also name reaction. Reimer-Thiemann reaction means phenol reacts with chloroform and NaOH. It gives ortho and para hydroxybenzaldehyde. Very same thing. Instead of chloroform, you can use carbon tetrachloride also. Carbon tetrachloride NaOH means instead of aldehyde group, we are going to add carboxylic acid group. Clear? The name is Reimer-Thiemann reaction. Reimer-Thiemann reaction. Reimer-Thiemann reaction. So Reimer-Thiemann reaction, what is the initial reactant? Phenol reacts with chloroform and NaOH. Chloroform NaOH. This is a formylation reaction. This is a formylation reaction. So, we are going to add in ortho 1CHO, very same thing in this phenol mean in para position 1CHO, namely ortho hydroxybenzaldehyde, para hydroxybenzaldehyde. You can write like this, ortho and para hydroxybenzaldehyde. Ortho and para hydroxybenzaldehyde. Now very same, one more reaction, in phenol, I am going to add instead of chloroform, CCl for carbon tetrachloride and NaOH. Carbon tetrachloride and NaOH. If you use instead of chloroform NaOH, instead of aldehyde, you are going to add carboxylic acid. So, ortho-hydroxybenzoic acid and para-hydroxybenzoic acid is the product. In ortho, which will be added here already? CHO. Now, COOH, here one COOH, namely, ortho-hydroxybenzoic acid, this is para-hydroxybenzoic acid. You can say like this, ortho and para-hydroxy benzoic acid. Nothing but what? Riemann-Thiemann reaction. So Riemann-Thiemann reaction mean phenol reacts with chloroform NaOH to form orthone parahydroxy benzaldehyde. Phenol reacts with chloroform carbon tetrachloride NaOH, it gives orthone parahydroxy benzoic acid. The next reaction, very very important reaction, namely saline fusion reaction. Preparation of indicator phenolphthalein. Saline fusion reaction. Very very easiest, interesting reaction. Saline fusion reaction. Saline fusion test. Saline fusion. Okay. Listen, ma'am. Here initially we are going to take, okay, phthalic anhydride. Phthalic anhydride couple reacts with phenol. In the presence of concentrated sulfuric acid, you will get our indicator, phenolphthalein. Okay. See here itself name. Phthalein is there. Phthalein. We are going to add phenol. Our product is phenolphthalein. Okay. Okay. Now, initially we are going to take phthalic anhydride. So first you have to know how to prepare phthalic anhydride. First, what is phthalic acid we will see. Phthalic acid means one benzene, listen ma, phthalic acid means contains two carboxylic acid group. C double bond O OH. C OH, C OH. So, namely what? Phthalic acid. What do you mean anhydride? There is no water. There is no water molecule means anhydride. Clear? So I am going to remove all of one water molecule. So this water, this O will come, become a in middle. So one benzene ring, C double bond O, O, C double bond O. Nothing but what? Phthalic anhydride. Phthalic anhydride. Clear? So yeah, for our reaction, for phthalein fusion test, the initial reactant is phthalic anhydride. So benzene ring, C double bond O, C double bond O, named as what? Phthalic anhydride. Phthalic anhydride. Okay. Now, reacts with phenol. I am going to take two molecules of phenol. Two molecules of reaction takes place in the presence of concentrated sulfuric acid. Listen ma, in all the corners, all the carbon containing one hydrogen atom. Okay, listen, I am going to remove the water molecule. I am going to remove the water molecule because already we got two bond, no, double bond. So one bond over here, another bond over here, that's the product. Okay, so one benzene ring, C double bond, O, C. Here is one benzene ring, OH. Here another benzene ring, OH, namely phenolphthalein. What? Phenolphthalein. What iteration we are using indicator now? That only this one. Okay. So phthalic anhydride reacts with phenol in the presence of consulfuric acid to form phenolphthalein. Okay. Then last one more condensation reaction, namely Lederer-Manessier reaction. Lederer-Manessier reaction means phenol condenses with formaldehyde in the presence of NaOH to form parahydroxy phenyl methanol. Okay, phenol. That is the phenol. You cannot have any carbon have OH mean phenol only. You can put OH here or here or here anyway. Okay. Anyway, that is phenol only. Phenol reacts with formaldehyde mean what? HCHO. HCHO. That is formaldehyde. Instead of HCHO, you can write CH2O also, no? HCHO mean, instead of HCHO, CH2O also formaldehyde only. Reaction takes place in the presence of sodium hydroxide. In all the positions, all the carbon have one extra hydrogen atom.
hydrogen, hydrogen, hydrogen. I'm going to indicate purposely this hydrogen alone.
Okay, you'll come to know later why I'm going to add here hydrogen. See now, the product is, already watch this person over here, CH2O combines this hydrogen to form CH2OH. Clear? CH2OH, namely para-hydroxy-phenyl-methanol. Para-hydroxy-phenyl-methanol. So, this very important reaction. See, first one is what? Coupling reaction. Phenol, benzene disodium chloride couples with phenol in the presence of base at 273 Kelvin to form a para-hydroxy. Para-hydroxy also benzene, red is orange dye, the certified dye formation reaction. Next one is Kolb reaction. Sodium phenoxide reacts with carbon dioxide, 400 Kelvin, 47 atmospheric pressure, it gives sodium salicylate. Sodium salicylate will decompose with HCl to form a salicylic acid. Then third one is Riemann-Thiemann reaction. Riemann-Thiemann reaction, phenol reacts with chloroform NaOH, you will get ortho and para-hydroxy, then aldehyde. Phenol reacts with carbon tetrachloride NaOH, you will get ortho and para-hydroxy benzoic acid. Isn't it? That's Riemann-Thiemann reaction. Then that is the thallin fusion reaction, mean thallic anhydride reacts with two molecules of phenol in the presence of consulfuric acid, you become a phenolphthalein. The very last name reaction, Lederer-Manasse reaction, phenol reacts with formaldehyde in the presence of base like NaOH to form a para-hydroxy-phenyl-methanol. Para-hydroxy-phenyl-methanol. Any doubt? Yeah, any doubt? Okay, ma'am. I think lesson